bulkheads locked down and the entire maintenance crew dissolved. Oh my god. They only found teeth. Holy crap. I'm not going home in a jar, so I've killed the security system lockdown. If that thing so much as pisses that ass in my direction, the system will reset all the security procedures. Safety first. Yeah, no kidding. You don't want the only thing left of you to be... teeth. Okay. If you cannot scream like that, I'd greatly appreciate it. Alright, so... So we can't really acquire anything in here. Just look at tanks and stuff. I don't like walking around in here when things are screaming their head off. I don't even know if that's a human being. So, not available now. Okay. So what about that other door? What is this thing here? Is that something I can... No, alright. Why can't I unlock the main freight elevator?
Are you expecting a beautiful bouncy baby boy or girl? Speak to your nearest administrator for details on our Mop and Toss program. You could win an all-expenses-pay vacation to Titan. Competition is sponsored by the C-Team.
Elevator control. I thought that sound was the elevator coming up. So what now? More blood and stuff. The interesting thing is there's things to look at, you know. But other than John. But yeah, we can't look at them. Like, I wonder what this thing is. You know,
I think that would break. I don't think this will fit.
Nah. This won't work either, but...
I think that would break. I think that'll just break it. It doesn't work like that.
I know, I'm so crazy.
I can't see it working like that.
You know, I think we want to get... the other robotic arm from in here. There's got to be something to do with this. Where are you going? The mechanism that holds the neural drill in place is unlocked and open.
I don't know what I was thinking there.
I don't know.
It doesn't work like that. Nah, that's ridiculous.
Maybe now that I have this thing retracted. What if I hit back? Well, it's just exit. Well, it sounds so pleasant.
This isn't gonna work. Probably not a good idea.
Just randomly trying stuff on. The bad thing is that sometimes when I drag it too far near the corner of the screen, that, effectively alt tabs out on Windows.
Probably not a good idea.
Alright, well, can I...
Maybe. No.
Maybe. Does it seem more valid to this one?
No. Crazy.
Crazy.
This isn't gonna work.
Alright. So we've got terminals, we've got cryo tubes, a steam coming out of mine, machinery.
Notice, manned maneuvering unit is awaiting input and instructions.
What? So you're saying something about a neutering unit? So it's Jackson. Just making sure there's not a second area. So this was mine. John Marachak. S. Anderson here. We've actually got two offline. And then Jackson. We can't see Jackson. Because the bodies are to the right of the terminal, aren't they?
It doesn't work like that. I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
Make it fit?
Maybe. No.
Alright, so I can't combine any items. Doesn't appear I can use anything here. I think what we need is this mechanical robotic arm, and then maybe the robotic arm can force open the door. That's what I'm thinking. It's just, how do we get the robotic arm? Or we can get a drill. Wait, I know what to do. I know exactly what to do. This should work. I will feel very happy if this works. So look, he automatically runs over there, right? That could be a hint. Now we hit the breaker box, turn off the power. It can't retract. Just hit another one and it'll overload. There we go. It can't retract with no power. So now we can get the neural drill. Sweet. Neural drill acquired. So what do we do with a neural drill? Obviously for using people's brains. So maybe I don't want the robotic arm? Extended.
I can try to make it fit, but it may break.
Okay. Can I combine anything?
I don't think this will fit. No. Crazy.
Agreed.
These don't go well together.
I agree there as well.
Emergency life support active.
I just think it's a good idea to have that on in general. I don't know if that's for the whole ship or not. Life support is always good. I mean, it makes sense that it would be through the entire ship, but then why would it be in the infirmary, necessarily, right? So, what if I try to use a neural drill on the door?
It doesn't work like that.
Oh, what a pity. What if I used to try to use a neural drill on this robotic... I'll try to use that too, but what about the robotic arm? Guess not.
Probably not a good idea.
Pity. So can I use it on our test subjects then? They're in pods though. See, I've achieved something, but maybe I can use it to get into the... LS. Security office. Something failed in the test. Report to security office. And someone else was whispering.
Maybe. No. No, that won't work. I don't think this will fit.
Alright. I don't know what to do with the neural drill. I mean, maybe we can use it to get past the locked door. I don't know.
It doesn't work like that. I don't know what I was thinking there.
Your bar of choice does it again. Puddle of Mud has an all-new sim stripper. She is oh so 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 hot. Visit us at 2/Sigma.
What?
Hey you, yes you over there. Ensure that you stay clean of parasites at all times.
Parasites.
No, that won't work.
Well, I worked so hard to get this thing and I have nothing to do with it now. Neural drill. Can I use it on myself? Oh, why are we doing this?
Attention, system rebooted, air scrubbers activated.
Oh, that's right.
Finally, some good news.
It affects the tanks as well, and you have to. They never fix that. Welcome to Kane Corporation. The rebooted monitoring system is slowly cycling and checking each subsystem. Tanks. Alright. Does that mean the lockdown will be cleared? It is. All right, before I go, she can now go through there or in there. Does it fix this other door? No. I guess we're gonna have to come back here at some other time. Yeah, I love you too. Alright. Bathe in a soft green light. How pleasing. Is he naked? Does he have a suit on? I don't know. Elevator control. P storage 1, P storage 2. Unspecified P something. P storage 3 maybe? Service lobby 1 and 2. So I should click that. Ah, pleasant music. There's a lot of room between floors.
Attention, product storage 2, Access to product storage 2 is denied until further notice.
How dare you? I specifically came down here. I can't even get out. A spinning red hologram indicates that the door is locked. Abandoned heavy loaders. The loaders sit huddled together like old pack dogs at the end of a long run. And this one doesn't exist. In the absence of a single signal, the screen flickers endlessly. Alright. Well, I guess we're not getting off here yet. Should I go to this unmarked one? Well, we can't. Alright. Service Lobby 1.
Attention, service platform 1. Please check in with the duty officer before engaging with any products.
Service platform 1. That was like service lobby. Portal. The room on the other side of the observation portal has a single bed in the center, surrounded by life support machinery. Beyond the observation portal stands an empty room containing a single chair. Nobody there? Children's toys lie in the room seen through the observation portal. A teddy bear is soaked in a red fluid, its matted hair plastered to the hard metal floor. Okay, our kid had a teddy bear. No reaction, John? Stoic to the end.
What were they doing here?
Killing people, apparently. A body bag? Dirt cakes the inside of the glass observation portal. Smeared blood makes it impossible to see into the room beyond. Well, we've got corpses and body bags. An adult-sized body bag lies abandoned on the floor. It appears to be full. Yeah, full of a body. Oh! What?
Oh, security holograms are still working.
That was a security hologram? So what turned into the corpse? Or was recording her death? Clara Daniels, General Nurse, Biome Labs. Personal data tag, security level 1. Oh, I have her PDA, I guess? Clara Daniels, General Nurse. New job! Sad. She's so enthusiastic, too. When Mike suggested I go and work in product storage, I honestly thought he was nuts. I mean, the pay is great and the hours are fantastic, but the job, well, I think it'll be boring. Yeah, you are. So bored, you died. Apparently, the only time a nurse is ever needed is when they crack a stasis tube open, which Robert, the admin office, said hardly ever happens. 9 times out of 10, they just take the pods directly to the different projects. I'm hopeful that we'll be able to open one soon. Tomorrow, I actually get to do some work that doesn't involve monitoring vital signs. We're opening a pod for Dr. Isaacs in Project Kitchen Knife. Oh, yeah. They said they need a specimen who is fully awake. These pods are filled with prisoners and drifters. They had their chance at a productive life and ruined it all. That's not necessary. That's necessarily true. One of them was working at a construction site or something. Tomorrow the first time. Okay, it doesn't show you, unfortunately, the the title. So I'm just going to go through this one. Damn drifters. Yesterday was much harder than I had imagined. When we opened the pod, the woman inside had no idea where she was. I'm aware that long-term stasis can cause disorientation, but she kept screaming for her husband, saying they were on their way to holiday on Europa. The doctor quickly sedated her and gave her a vocal cord numbing agent to stop the screaming. Oh, God. I mean, she was obviously lying about being a holiday maker. These drifters will say anything to get out of this situation. My God, that's true. I'm sure it's true. Some of them going on vacation. It's just been so long. Right, they're in the future now. I mean, have family, will travel. You can travel hundreds of years in the future. It's just you're going to miss your friends who aren't traveling likewise and other family members. But if you don't have everyone else, then it doesn't really matter, right? As long as you're safe when you get out. These people are not safe. Being victimized by other human beings. So I wonder if this is his, if this is his wife. I wonder if they were on the way to a vacation. They didn't react at all to the observation room with the teddy bear in it. I thought he would. More prisoners. We got another two products in this morning. Transfers from a penal colony on Earth. I asked to have a look at their files, hoping it would make this a little easier, but I was told that all records are sealed. Yeah, then you would find out these people are telling the truth. They're not all prisoners. He didn't even scream. I had to delete the last few logs. I read them over again, but they were just too painful. I can still hear the crying of the last man we thawed out. He didn't even scream. He sat on the bed crying until the doctors came in. They tagged him and took him down to the labs. He didn't even scream. Should he scream? I guess he should scream. Maybe he had no idea what lay in store for him. There must be a mistake. Yesterday we opened up a pod with a 10-year-old boy in it. There must have been some sort of mistake. Even if he was a drifter, he's a child. His name is Neil. He's in rehabilitation downstairs. I asked to go and visit him, but was told that it would be easier for me if I just let things be. Yeah, not too threatening. Leaving product storage. I want out of product storage. I requested a transfer to the biomes. I think hydroponics will cheer me up. The pay isn't as good, but at least I'll be able to sleep at night. Biomes, not what I thought. I heard the department heads talking about getting something from product storage. They already have 4 unopened stasis pods in the lab, but they're looking for a subject that can respond immediately. This isn't right. Not just a hydroponics bay. They're using products from product storage, too. I thought this was just a hydroponics bay. What the hell would they need human specimens for? Sarah told me that there are more children in the rehabilitation centers under product storage. I'm going there tonight. These security lockdowns have been happening more frequently. I'm going to use them to my advantage. Tomorrow, I'm going to get those kids out of here. Oh, I don't think that worked out the way you wanted it to. Today is a day. I'm leaving these entries on this PDA so that if I disappear, you'll know what happened. Whoever's reading this, you need to help. Please help those children. Yeah, and myself. Okay. The airtight enclosure of the body bag has made it difficult to judge how long this corpse has been lying here. The two child-sized body bags lie very close to one another as if for warmth. Oh boy.
Could do something like this. Oh God. I need to get to Rebecca.
The body of a child. You almost feel guilty within the flood of relief when you realize it's not your own. The outline of a child can be seen in the body bag. Mm-hmm. Gonna be relieved again.
I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Yeah, that is. The dead child's eyes stare directly at you as if in recrimination. The outline of a human adult can be seen in the body bag. What's that? That one is a green thing. Judging from the toe tag, this body had already been processed by some departmental facility. Is that the toe tag that's gleaming? What is that? Electronic toe tag.
I think that'll just break it.
I don't do anything with it. Well, that's incredibly sad. Biometric terminal.
Attention. Biometric handprint not recognized. The mortuary requires level 5 security access.
I don't suppose I can use the toe tag, can I?
It doesn't work like that.
I don't think so. What about the nurse's, hand? Does she have clearance? I guess I can't take her hand off. Okay. I'm severely saddened and creeped out. Okay. Dead bodies, dead kids. They're making people think they're criminals, which even if they were, they're human beings. But no, they're not criminals. Maybe some of them are, but yeah, not an excuse anyway. And those little kids, those people trying to go on vacation. And, yeah, no good, no bueno. Alright, so we're gonna cut it off here. I will see you next episode. I guess we'll try that last that bottom floor in the, elevator. We'll see what I can do. Maybe I can do something else with the electronic toe tag. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always, seek adventure.